So part of disease management is doing actual inspections. So if you're never in the colony, it's kind of hard to know if there's any problems in there. Again, you don't need to have big, really long inspections. For example, 5-10 minutes with experience, you can probably inspect half the frames and get a really good indication of the general health of that colony. And I'd say here I do it 10 to 14 days, but when you're first starting off, I'd say every 5 days is fine, 5 to 7 days, because you need to get really a good understanding of these colonies. And in the next slide, I'll show you a trick you could use so that you don't over manipulate some frames. So if you're going to do it every 5 days, if you always pull out the same frames, you might stress the colony out. So what I started doing on a few hives is I have a big Sharpie and I actually write what's a honey frame. So if you can see the HHC, so an empty comb. So drawn comb, brood, 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 comb, comb, honey, empty. So I like Sharpies because probably after about a month, you won't be able to see it anymore. But what I do sometimes is I might put the date or an X on this frame and I'll do my inspection in this direction and I'll inspect 5 frames this way, week one. And then the following week, I'll inspect this way. So if you just put a Sharpie mark here and have a code or something, the date that you inspected, then you know to start from this side. And that way in a 10-day period, you'll have seen the, all 10 frames in that box. So keep a Sharpie and you can do whatever you want with it. There's no right or wrong. So here, for example, are things that sometimes I have a piece of duct tape on some of my colonies on the lids. And I put so this is a Yukon Queen from 2018. So I just put YT there. Most of my queens come from BC. So I just say BC 2000 or sorry, BC 20. Queen right, seems to be, so if I might have 7 SB, so how many seams of bees? So for example, in this box here, I'd say this is a partial, but 7.5 to 8 frames of bees. Okay, so frames of brood, so there's 3 frames. And frames of honey, so there's 3 frames of honey, and a date of inspection. So I would just use a piece of duct tape and you write it on there with your Sharpie and it's all good. And for example, I inspected this colony 10 days after this, and these 2 C's now were bees. So they had brood on them. So when I did my assessment, now this colony went from 3 frames of brood to 5 frames of brood. And so this colony is heading in the right direction. So I haven't really talked about diseases yet, but if you keep healthy colonies, diseases aren't an issue. Okay, so first sign of chalk brood. I use screen bottom boards with inserts. And I think I talked about this in that first talk, but these are chalk brood mummies. Okay, so if I see this on my screen bottom board, I know that I have chalk brood, and then I'll check the frames just to see how bad it is. If it's minor, I'll just throw some feed on, maybe a pollen patty, and I might put an extra box or change the boxes to fresh poly or a fresh wooden box just to give them a new hive home. So, because sometimes humidity and cold influences them. Okay. Oh, there's somebody in the waiting room. I think they're good. So let's see. And the reason I really like my screen bottom boards is for mites. Okay, so natural drop, you can see if you have mites, and I'd say that's the extent of a screen bottom board, is a natural drop will tell you I've got mites, yes or no. Okay, it won't tell you how many, because in the last 5 years of monitoring, haven't seen a relationship between how many mites and what the natural drop is. A natural drop is a dead mite or a groom mite falling off a bee and then making its way down to the debris board below the screen bottom board. And technically you would check, you would clean the board off, insert your insert, and then come back in 3 days and count how many mites you find and then divide it by three. And that would give you a drop for 24 hours. Okay, so I do an OAV and then I count the mite drop and then I get a higher count and it tells me more. So for example, this was after a oxalic acid treatment. I think I might've had 5 mites per 24 hours. Not even that, maybe 3 mites. And you can see I did a treatment and in here, ballpark, there's a couple of hundred mites here. And year one, probably not an issue. Okay, so the colony will probably make it through. But year two is where you start seeing issues with viruses and potentially them not overwintering. And sometimes it gets so bad that it starts affecting your brood. And that's where PMS comes in, so parasitic mite syndrome. So that's why if you get a new nook or a package, usually mites aren't really an issue until year two, okay? So we tend to hold off our treatment till the first fall or the following year. And then we wonder why we're having such trouble ramping that colony up. So my recommendations for most folks is treat when you get that package. So install them, give them a couple of days to get comfy, maybe a week, because they won't have time to really drought and cap their cells, especially if you're starting with like new equipment with no drawn comb. You've got a good week before, a week to 10 days before they start really capping anything, if even that. You've got more time than that. If you've got drawn comb, the queen might actually start laying almost right away. So you've got, I'd say, 5-6 days before they start capping cells. So, or 8 days. So it's important that you don't wait too long.